A very good morning and Jai Hind children. Welcome to chemistry class. Children, we were doing the chapter Chemical Effects of Electric Current, that is chapter number 15. I hope you are clear with the all previous topics. And in the previous class, we have talked about electrolysis. So what is electrolysis? Electrolysis is a technique in which when a current is passed, what happens? The electrolyte. What is electrolyte? That is the liquid that is present in a beaker or any container. It breaks into its respective ions and it is transported to electrode. And we know that there are two types of electrodes, anode and cathode. Isn't it? We have two charges, positive and negative. Okay, so anode is positive and cathode is negative. Okay, so anode is positive and cathode is negative. These are the two electrodes. And the electrolyte is the liquid that is present in a beaker or something like that, which contains the respective ions, or we can say it that it acts as a conductor. Kyunki wo conductor hai, isliye usme ions ya charged particle present honge. Like for example, we have seen copper sulfate. So copper and sulfate. Alright. So copper is positively charged and sulfate is negatively charged. So they are containing ions. So when electricity is passed through that electrolyte, it will break into positive and negative charges. Alright. So this process of breaking down of a chemical or an electrolyte into its respective ions with the help of electric current, this is called electrolysis. Alright, so this we have talked about in the previous classes. We have studied electrolysis in the previous class. Now children, today we will talk about the very important topic, that is uses of electrolysis. So we have seen what is electrolysis, we have seen what is the procedure of electrolysis, we have seen that. Now we will study why this electrolysis is important and what is the application of the electrolysis. Okay, so I am going to share the PPT, and children, I have sent you the worksheet. I hope you have done that. So I am going to share the PPT now. Okay, and then we will continue with the explanation. So here you can see that there are three basic uses of electrolysis, that is electroplating, extraction of metal and purification of metals. So all these three topics we are going to study today. Okay, so first let's start with what is electroplating. As the name says, plating. Plating ka yahan pe matlab hai किसी के ऊपर किसी चीज की कोटिंग चढ़ा देना, उसको हम बोलते हैं प्लेटिंग. व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रोप्लेटिंग? व्हेन अ मेटल इज कोटेड ओवर अनदर मेटल. हम एक कोई मेटल है उसके ऊपर दूसरे मेटल की अगर लेयर को चढ़ा देते हैं और कोट कर देते हैं, दैट इज कॉल्ड इलेक्ट्रोप्लेटिंग. And when it is done by the process of electrolysis, it is called electroplating. Okay, so let's see the what is written in the chapter. So we have uses of electrolysis. So in uses of electrolysis, first we have electroplating. What is electroplating? So electrolysis has a number of applications. The most common of these is electroplating. What is electroplating? Coating a thin layer of metal such as gold, silver, chromium, tin, nickel over the another cheaper metal. It is called electroplating. Children, we see various products in the market. We go to market to purchase a jewelry. We purchase certain household materials like we purchase a handlebar, we have a bike, and also there is a coating of certain metals that we will see. We can see a tap that is also coated with certain metals. Then we have certain, basically we have seen it in a jewelry and a bike material or something like that. They don't have a pure iron material or a pure gold material. उसमें क्या होता है, कोई cheap सा metal होगा, cheap metal, it means that कोई सस्ता सा metal होगा, उसके ऊपर क्या करते हैं कि coating कर देते हैं, like gold की या chromium की या tin की, आप coating कर देते हैं उसके ऊपर, and then you purchase, then you sell it in the market. Okay, we see various products around us that are not pure, but it is coated with certain metals. Okay, so this is called electroplating. When this process is done with the help of electrolysis, it is called electroplating. Getting it? So let's see what is electroplating and where these are used. So as you can see in the figure here, as you can see a handlebar. ये हैंडल बार है आपके घर में भी कभी अगर इस शाइनी मटेरियल का अगर हैंडल लगा है दैट हैंडल इज कोटेड विद क्रोमियम गेटिंग इट दैट हैंडल इज कोटेड विद क्रोमियम ओके वॉश बेसिन में आपके ये जो नल लगा होता है द टैप दैट यू सी इज आल्सो कोटेड विद क्रोमियम ओके नाउ व्हाई दीज थिंग्स आर डन There are two basic reason. First reason is to protect the metal. ठीक है? Metal को protect करने के लिए हम उसके ऊपर दूसरे metal की coating कर देते हैं. First, second, to look it, to make it more shiny and to make it more flawless, हम उसको क्या करते हैं? उसके ऊपर किसी चीज की coating कर देते हैं. And the third, कुछ metals ऐसे होते हैं जैसे कि iron, जो किसी भी प्रोडक्ट से रिएक्ट कर जाते हैं तो वो रिएक्ट ना करें इसलिए हम उसके ऊपर कोटिंग कर देते हैं ओके सो सिमिलरली व्हेन यू सी अ टेबल जिसमें आयरन रॉड लगी होती है हम उसके ऊपर पेंट कर देते हैं ऑलराइट वी पेंटेड और वी कोटेड विद सर्टेन डिफरेंट मेटल सो दैट उसमें रस्टिंग ना हो आयरन है तो आयरन में रस्टिंग इजली हो जाती है अगर हम उसको किसी और मेटल से कोट कर देंगे तो रस्टिंग इजली नहीं होगी सो दीज आर द रीजंस व्हाई इलेक्ट्रोप्लेटिंग इज डन एंड इलेक्ट्रोप्लेटिंग इज अ वेरी कॉमन एग्जांपल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलाइसिस ओके सो व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रोप्लेटिंग चिल्ड्रन इलेक्ट्रोप्लेटिंग इज अ प्रोसेस इन विच A thin layer of a metal is coated over another cheaper metal that is called electroplating. Okay, this is done either to protect the metal or to make it look attractive. या तो हम metal को protect करते हैं, या तो उसको attractive बनाने के लिए हम उसपे दूसरे metal की coating करते हैं. Like in case of gold plated jewelries, what happens? Why we are coating a gold over that metal to make it more attractive. But in case of this tin plated can, ये जो Pepsi या Coke या Sprite की can होती है, इसके ऊपर tin की layer होती है. ये iron नहीं होता है, ये tin या tin की layer होती है. Why? Because if we make it of iron, what will happen? It will react with the Coke or Pepsi that is inside it. ओके और वो कुछ कई हार्मफुल सब्सटेंस क्रिएट कर देगा दैट इज व्हाई दिस टिन इज प्लेटेड ओवर इट ओके एंड एट टाइम्स हाउ यू कैन सी इट वेदर इट इज प्लेटेड और नॉट सो आफ्टर सेवरल यूजेस आफ्टर सेवरल फोल्ड्स क्या होता है कि उसका जो ओरिजिनल शाइन होता है ना वो धीरे धीरे चला जाता है स्पेशली फॉर गर्ल्स इफ यू हैव एवर परचेज गोल्ड प्लेटेड ज्वेलरी फ्रॉम द मार्केट What happens after several use and several washes? What happens? कि उसके जो gold की shine है, if it is not pure, it is gold plated. तो क्या होगा? उसकी shine चली जाती है and the actual metal that is inside it will be visible. Okay? जिससे आप ये चीज पता कर सकते हैं कि whether it is plated gold or it is normal gold or a original gold. Okay, so this is a process called electroplating. Let's see where electroplatings are done. So chromium is a shiny metal, as you can see here in this tap and a handle. So this is a shiny metal that does not corrode or resist scratches. इसमें अगर आप scratch कर रहे हो तो scratch नहीं आएगा, इसमें जल्दी rusting नहीं होगी, ये corrode नहीं होगा easily. That is why chromium is used. It is deposited on other cheaper metals such as iron to make car parts, taps, bicycle handles, bars, wheel rims, etc. This make them look more attractive and also resist corrosion. So these are the figures that you can see here. I'll show you few more figures. So see, this is electroplating. Coating of thin layer of metal over another cheaper metal is called electroplating. As you can see in the first figure, that is a tap is electroplated with chromium. Second, we have a bike. So bike ke jitne bhi engines hain, which you see as a shiny, which has a shiny texture of a steel like material, it is not a steel or a iron, it is chromium. Okay, so all these part is coated with chromium. And also when you ride a bicycle, so the handle of bicycle is also coated with chromium, okay, by the process of electroplating. And electroplating is nothing but a process of electrolysis, okay. And various tools we see around us, it is also electroplated with chromium, okay. So these are a plated chromium material. Now there are several jewelries. See, the first and second jewelry, as you can see, they are not pure gold, they are plated with gold. Is pe gold ki polish hui hai, so in general terms we say that gold ki polish hui hai is pe. It is not pure gold. So andar material kuch aur hai, metal kuch aur hai, uske upar gold ki thin layer humne प्लेट कर दिए. सो इट इज अ गोल्ड प्लेटेड ज्वेलरी. ओके, सिमिलरली फिगर नंबर 3 and 4 इज अ सिल्वर प्लेटेड ज्वेलरी. इस पे सिल्वर प्लेटेड बैंगल एंड सिल्वर प्लेटेड गिफ्ट दैट यू कैन सी. सो दे आर नॉट प्योर सिल्वर मटेरियल बट दे आर कोटेड विद सिल्वर. ओके, सिमिलरली द फोर्थ रिंग दैट यू कैन सी हियर is platinum plated. इस पे platinum की plating की गई है. It is not pure platinum. It में platinum की coating की गई है. Alright. So this is the application of electrolysis, or this is the application of electroplating. Okay. These are the process. ये सारी की सारी चीजें electroplating के through बनी हैं. Then we can see several this containers that is not pure iron made or something like that, because we cannot put a food product in iron container. Why? Because it can get easily react, it can easily react with the food items. So we are not putting the things in iron container, so we use a plated this container. So this container, as you can see here, is plated with tin. Getting it? It is plated with tin, so it is tin plated container. Similarly, in paint industry, what happens, the container that is made where the paint is put, so that container is also made up of tin. Okay, so all these materials are plated with tin. Getting it? They are not iron or something like that. Then we can coat zinc also. So in various automobiles, when certain automobiles are made and bridges are made, certain tools are used, like a screw and nuts and all these things are used. So they are also electroplated with certain things, like certain metals like zinc and copper. तो उसपे क्या होती है कि plating की जाती है, उसके ऊपर एक coating, एक layer चढ़ाई जाती है. That is called electroplating. Getting it? Let's see what is written in the chapter. So, we have talked about the first point. Let's go to the second point. Gold or silver is electroplated on jewelry, made up of cheaper metal to make it look attractive. That I have told you that the jewelries are made up of cheaper material, but it is electroplated with gold and silver. Okay, it is electroplated with gold and silver to make it more attractive. Okay, then food kept in iron cans gets spoiled. Kharab ho jate hain agar iron mein rakhe jayenge, iron ke container mein, because of reaction with iron. To prevent this, iron is electroplated with tin. तो इस चीज को फूड के स्पॉइलेज को प्रिवेंट करने के लिए द कंटेनर और अ कैन इज इलेक्ट्रोप्लेटेड विद टिन व्हिच इज लेस रिएक्टिव देन आयरन टू मेक टिन कैन्स दे आर यूज्ड टू स्टोर फूड ऑलराइट सो दिस आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड इट टू यू सो इट इज इलेक्ट्रोप्लेटेड विद टिन और सर्टेन मटेरियल डिफरेंट फ्रॉम आयरन नाउ Zinc is electroplated on iron used to make bridges and automobiles. The coating prevents iron from rusting. So various bridges and automobiles are also coated with zinc material so that it does not get rusted. Usme rusting na ho, wo jaldi kharab na ho jaye. Isliye usme zinc ki coating ki jati hai. Alright. So these are few application and few uses of electroplating, and electroplating is a very common application of electrolysis. Getting it? Now children, the very important part of this chapter is this activity, that is activity 5. Okay, so when school will reopen, we'll perform this activity, but first we'll try to understand what is there in this activity. This activity basically demonstrates how electroplating is done. Okay, so first I'll explain it to you here and then I'll explain you on the board. Okay, so the activity is to electroplate a metal object with copper in the laboratory. Hame kya karna hai? Hamare paas ek ye spoon hai. Aap ye spoon dekh rahe ho? We have a spoon. Hame is spoon pe कॉपर की प्लेटिंग करनी है ठीक है तो कॉपर की प्लेटिंग करने के लिए हम क्या करते हैं फर्स्ट विल टेक अ बीकर विल टेक अ वाटर एंड विल ऐड कॉपर सल्फेट टू इट व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू ऐड कॉपर सल्फेट एंड वी विल स्टिर इट ठीक तो इट विल बिकम अ कॉपर सल्फेट सॉल्यूशन तो बीकर में हमने लिक्विड क्या लिया है हमने लिक्विड लिया है कॉपर सल्फेट सॉल्यूशन का ओके दिस इज अ कॉपर सल्फेट सॉल्यूशन गेटिंग इट नाउ व्हाट वी हैव डन वी हैव टेकन वन कॉपर वायर दिस इज अ कॉपर प्लेट और अ कॉपर वायर वी हैव कनेक्टेड दिस कॉपर वायर विद अ पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल दैट इज एनोड एंड वी हैव कनेक्टेड स्पून जिसके ऊपर हमें कॉपर की प्लेटिंग करनी है with a negative terminal that is cathode okay humne iron rod copper rod ko anode se connect kiya aur spoon jis pe hame coating karni hai usko humne negative terminal of battery se connect kar diya we'll keep it for some time as it is okay we'll keep it as it is for some time nearly half an hour theek hai tab kya hoga This copper will be plated over this spoon. Again, spoon कैसा हो जाएगा? इसके ऊपर copper की plating हो जाएगी. There will be a plating of copper over this spoon. Getting it? When you take it out, there will be a plating of copper over this spoon. Now, what is the mechanism behind it? This we have to study here. Okay? So first I'll read the activity and then we'll continue with this. So you need a glass beaker. We have taken a glass beaker. a thick copper wire, a metal spoon, a battery cell, a solution of copper sulfate. Okay, connecting wire and a switch. These are the materials required. Now, fill around 3/4 of the beaker with copper sulfate solution. हमने इस बीकर में क्या किया है? कॉपर सल्फेट का सॉल्यूशन लिया है. ओके, हैमर द कॉपर वायर टू फ्लैटन इट आउट एंड कनेक्ट इट टू द पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ द बैटरी. जो ये वायर है, वी हैव फ्लैटन्ड इट, वी हैव टेकन अ फ्लैट कॉपर वायर एंड वी हैव कनेक्टेड इट टू अ पॉजिटिव टर्मिनल दैट इज एनोड. नाउ कनेक्ट द स्पून थ्रू अ स्विच टू अ नेगेटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ द बैटरी. स्पून को हमने स्विच, दिस इज अ स्विच एंड अ नेगेटिव टर्मिनल ऑफ अ बैटरी से कनेक्ट कर दिया. ओके, डिप बोथ ऑफ देम इन अ कॉपर सल्फेट सॉल्यूशन, मेकिंग श्योर दैट दे डू नॉट टच ईच अदर. चिल्ड्रन, व्हाई दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट टू मेक अ डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दीज टू, बिकॉज इफ दे विल बी क्लोज इनफ then the circuit will be complete. Even the circuit is now complete, but there can be an electric shock. We can get an electric shock agar ye dono cheeze pass pass hongi, like copper wire and spoon. Agar dono pass pass hai to kya hoga? We can get an electric shock. Okay, so that is why there needs to, like, a distance has to be maintained between the two. Put on the switch and let the current pass. So when we'll on the switch, the current will flow through the solution for about half an hour. Does a layer of copper get deposited on the spoon? Yes, definitely. After half an hour, when you'll put out this spoon out, then you will see a copper is deposited over the spoon. Now, what is the principle behind it? What is the procedure that is taking place here? So, see, when copper sulfate is dissolved in water, it forms a positively charged copper ion and a negatively charged sulfate ion. ठीक है? Copper break हो जाएगा, copper sulfate break हो जाएगा, copper और sulfate. I'll make it clear to you. So, just a moment. Alright, so I'll make it clear, children. So what we have taken, first we have taken, so let's see. So this is a beaker, this is a beaker that we have taken. We have added a copper sulfate solution in it. So this we have a copper sulfate solution. Okay, we have taken an iron rod or a copper rod. Okay, we have taken a spoon. Okay, take it as a spoon. Now this copper wire is connected to the positive terminal and this spoon is connected to a negative terminal of the battery. Okay, now as soon as we on the switch, now what happens? We on the switch. Now the moment we will on the switch, what will happen? The moment we will on the switch, the current will flow. All right, the current will flow. Now this is an electrolyte. This solution is what? This is an electrolyte. Okay, so copper sulfate will break and copper will have a positive ion and sulfate will have a negative. So copper is positively charged and sulfate is negatively charged. So in the solution we'll have copper positive and we will also have sulfate negative. Getting it? Now as the rule says, positive charge is attracted towards negative. तो ये कॉपर क्या करेगा, किसकी तरफ अट्रैक्ट होगा, नेगेटिव की तरफ. सो दिस कॉपर विल गेट डिपॉजिटेड ओवर दिस नेगेटिवली चार्ज्ड स्पून. गेटिंग इट, क्योंकि पॉजिटिव किसकी तरफ अट्रैक्ट होता है, नेगेटिव की तरफ, तो ये अट्रैक्ट हो जाएगा. ओके, नाउ द क्वेश्चन कम्स दैट एक बार ये ब्रेक हुआ तो कॉपर सारा जाके इसमें अट्रैक्ट हो गया, देन व्हाट विल हैपन. तो एनोड पे क्या होगा, अगेन दिस कॉपर, फ्रॉम दिस कॉपर वायर द कॉपर अगेन विल बी लिबरेटेड आउट. इसमें से कॉपर निकल रहा है, इट इज गेटिंग डिसॉल्व्ड इन द सॉल्यूशन एंड इट इज गेटिंग ट्रांसफर टू द नेगेटिव चार्ज. Getting it, because positive is getting attracted towards negative, and the sulfate will do nothing. The sulfate will remain as it is and will form an impurity here. Okay, that we'll talk about in the later section. Okay, let's see now. Let's see what is written in the chapter. I hope you have understood it. Like few points you have understood it. Let's see what is written. So see, this point you have understood. When copper sulfate is dissolved in water, जब copper sulfate water में dissolved है, it form positively charged copper ion. ये copper ion बना लेगा, that is Cu plus, okay? And a negatively charged sulfate ion, that is SO 4 minus, okay? When an electric current is passed through the solution. The copper ion, that is positive charge, move towards cathode, that is negative charge, pick up the electron from there and get deposited on its copper atom. The same thing that I have told you, that copper ion will be attracted towards a negative, that is cathode, and will be deposited over the atom. Okay? And will be deposited over that atom. Now, at the anode yani ke positive terminal pe kya hoga? The copper atom in the copper plate lose electron to form a copper ion. The ions go into the solution. Copper jo rod hai, as you can see here, this is a copper rod. Isme se kya hoga? Copper निकल जाएगा, वो सॉल्यूशन में डिपॉजिट हो जाएगा एंड दैट कॉपर विल अगेन बी ट्रांसपोर्टेड टू द नेगेटिव चार्ज. ओके, आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट टू यू अगेन, जस्ट अ मोमेंट, आई विल एक्सप्लेन दिस टू यू अगेन. सो व्हाट हैपेंस हियर, अगेन आई विल टेल यू. सो दिस इज नेगेटिव चार्ज, सॉरी दिस इज पॉजिटिव चार्ज, this is negative charge. In the solution we have, let me erase it and I'll explain it to you again, just a moment. So children, we have two things here. We have a copper wire that is attached to the positive terminal and we have a spoon. जरूरी नहीं है कि यहाँ पे स्पून हो, हम कोई और भी सब्सटेंस ले सकते हैं, की ले सकते हैं या कुछ और भी ले सकते हैं. एंड देन वी हैव अ इलेक्ट्रोलाइट सॉल्यूशन, वी हैव अ इलेक्ट्रोलाइट सॉल्यूशन दैट इज कॉपर सल्फेट. तो जब हमने यहाँ पे इलेक्ट्रिक करंट पास किया, व्हेन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इज पास्ड, देन व्हाट हैपेंस, कॉपर इज present in this solution and it is negatively charged, तो copper ion क्या करेगा, जाके इस पे attach हो जाएगा. Negative charge का क्या मतलब होता है, electron. So now what will happen if we'll see at cathode. So at cathode what is going to happen, copper ion will take the electron from here and will, क्योंकि ये पॉजिटिव और ये नेगेटिव, तो ये किसमें कन्वर्ट हो जाएगा? सिंपल कॉपर एटम में. ओके, इट विल बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू कॉपर एटम. नाउ व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन एट एनोड? एनोड यानी कि यहां पे क्या हो रहा है, यहां पे क्या हो रहा है, वी हैव अ कॉपर एटम. यहां पे क्या है, ये कॉपर एटम है, इसमें कोई चार्ज नहीं है. नाउ इट विल बी डिसोसिएटेड, ओके, एंड विल लूज द इलेक्ट्रॉन. इट विल लूज द इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड विल गेट पॉजिटिवली चार्ज्ड. सो व्हेन इट इज लूजिंग द इलेक्ट्रॉन, इट विल गेट पॉजिटिवली चार्ज्ड. So when it is getting positively charged, it will again mix into this aqueous solution and it will be transferred to the spoon. Okay, so that was about the experiment. So we'll talk about this experiment. When we'll perform this experiment, you will understand it better. This is the electroplating of copper over another metal. Okay. Therefore, the anode slowly dissolves into the solution while the layer of copper gets deposited on the cathode. Copper gets transferred from anode to cathode. Okay, and this complete setup is called electrolytic cell. Children, please go through this topic. If you are not able to understand it, I'll explain it to you again in the next class. Okay. If you have any doubts, please do ask. If you want me to repeat this topic, then also ask me in the group. So that's all for today's class, children. I'll send you one worksheet. Please try to solve that worksheet so that you can understand it better. So that's all for today's class. Thank you and Jai Hind, everyone.